Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. This video describes the recently approved drug momelotinib, sold under the brand name OJJAARA. This video emphasizes the MedChem properties of the drug rather than the compound's clinical pharmacology. If you happen to be a scientist who worked on this project and are able to speak about this research or your general work at GSK, I would be very interested in interviewing you for a separate video. The channel email address is in the video description. Momelotinib was approved by the FDA on the 15th of September in 2023. The active pharmaceutical ingredient is momelotinib, which is the U.S. adopted name and international non-proprietary name. The branded name of the drug is OJJAARA. Momelotinib is administered once a day orally, and in a typical dose of 200 milligrams, momelotinib is indicated for the treatment of intermediate and high-risk myelofibrosis in adults with anemia. GlaxoSmithKline sponsored the NDA, although the original NDA was filed by Sierra Oncology, which was recently acquired by GSK. Incidentally, momelotinib has quite a development history and has been held in the past by other companies as well. Let's start with momelotinib's indication, myelofibrosis, or MF. MF is a type of chronic leukemia and leads to the development of scar tissue in the bone marrow. The disease is rare at just 1.5 annual cases per 100,000 people. The damage from scarring leads to anemia, and enlargement of the spleen is often observed in addition to many other symptoms, such as night sweats and itching. Patients with myelofibrosis have a median survival rate of 6 years, so this is a disease with severe health consequences. Momelotinib's mechanism of action is inhibition of Janus kinase, or JAK. In particular, momelotinib is reportedly selective for the JAK1 and JAK2 isoforms, as well as a JAK2 mutant. We'll come back to this selectivity later. JAK inhibition is associated with blood cell component formation and immune response, as well as inflammation. Momelotinib also hits another target, activin receptor-like kinase 2, ALK2. Inhibition of this kinase is associated with increasing red blood cell production to help address the anemia aspects of myelofibrosis. I do not typically discuss much clinical pharmacology in these drug approval videos, mainly because I do not know much about clinical pharmacology. Clinical pharmacology is more on the drug development side of the coin, and my knowledge is more on the drug discovery side. I am making an exception in this video because I found some of the prescribing information a bit interesting. So drugs are approved based on achieving endpoints, which are described as clinical outcomes. Clinical trial outcomes are how a patient feels, how a patient functions, or survival rate. These are different from biomarker changes that are often monitored in preclinical studies. In the case of momelotinib, the researchers used a clinical outcome assessment called MFSAF version 4.0 Total Symptom Score. That's the Myelofibrosis Symptom Assessment Form. So a patient could take the medication, use a diary to record the severity of their symptoms, such as fatigue, itching, abdominal pain, etc. Within these symptoms, you can see the effects of myelofibrosis, and hopefully the benefits arising from JAK inhibition by the drug. Use of clinical outcome assessment tools like the MFSAF score allow comparison of outcomes in patients across different treatments without needing to continuously poke and prod patients in a medical setting. Patients can self-report their symptoms for analysis of the data at a later time. I mentioned the comparison of different treatments. Let's see some different myelofibrosis drugs that share momelotinib's same mechanism of action, JAK inhibition. Here are four JAK inhibitors, including momelotinib in the upper right. To the upper left is ruxolotinib. In the lower left is fedratinib. In the lower right is pacritinib. All these compounds share common features to one degree or another, some less, others more. All these compounds are now approved by the FDA for intermediate and high-risk myelofibrosis. Let's focus on the structure of momelotinib. We can see that the molecular weight is very typical for an orally administered drug at a bit over 400 grams per mole. Momelotinib has a very moderate log P and reasonable values for the number of hydrogen bond acceptors and hydrogen bond donors. All of these properties are consistent with a compound with high membrane permeability and potentially high oral absorption. Here are some of the potencies of momelotinib on different targets, all kinases. These values are pulled from IUPAR's Guide to Pharmacology website. In my judgment, these potencies are fairly comparable, as much as one can directly compare IC50 values. The prescribing information does specifically note that the inhibitory activity of momelotinib and its metabolites is higher for JAK2 than JAK3 and tyrosine kinase 2. I guess that could be true, but I'm not sure that these numbers establish meaningful selectivity. Regardless, momelotinib is fairly potent with close to single-digit nanomolar potency across the board against these targets. There are few X-ray structures of momelotinib co-crystals. One structure involves ALK2, a secondary kinase target of momelotinib, while no momelotinib JAK co-crystals have been reported in the literature, I would guess that those co-crystals are known within some drug companies, as JAK-based co-crystals are well represented in the PDB. Before we look at the co-crystal reference on this slide, please do note the nature of momelotinib. It is essentially a flat molecule with conjugation from one side of the molecule to the other. With this in mind, let's look at this co-crystal. Here is the co-crystal. Let's change the view a bit to highlight just the amino acids in the binding pocket and the inhibitor. We can see the binding pocket is a deep cleft in the protein. The flat shape of the inhibitor, which is in dark gray, allows it to slip into this cleft. ALK2 is a catalytic receptor, not an enzyme like the JAK isoforms. Therefore, I want to be clear that I am not inferring that we can necessarily understand JAK binding based on the interactions we see in the structure. The activity of momelotinib on ALK2 is regardless relevant for the therapeutic benefit of the drug. The key PK parameters of momelotinib are on the screen. The half-life is between 4 and 8 hours. The clearance is 103 liters per hour, and the volume of distribution is 984 liters. Alternate units are shown below each value, based on a typical patient mass of 70 kilograms. The bioavailability is not disclosed in the prescribing information. Based on the drug's clearance, I suspect that the bioavailability is on the lower end, like 25% or lower, but that is just a guess. Plasma protein binding is high, and essentially none of the drug is excreted unchanged in the urine. In terms of metabolism, there is just one metabolite of note, M21. This metabolite arises through CYP-mediated oxidation of the morpholine ring, followed by an oxidation by aldehyde oxidase to give lactam M21. Based on the structure of momelotinib, I was fairly certain that this very electron-rich ring would be the site of some metabolism. But all the observed metabolites either involve the morpholine ring, the nitrile, or the amide. So There you go. Sometimes metabolites are not easy to predict. Metabolite M21 does retain approximately 40% of the activity of the parent drug and is responsible for some of the observed therapeutic benefit. Note that the identity of the various metabolites of momelotinib was reported in 2018 by scientists at Gilead, which was a previous owner of the rights to momelotinib. Momelotinib carries many safety risks, which is not surprising for an oncology drug. Many of these can be directly traced to the on-target activity of momelotinib, which affects the marrow and blood composition, as well as influences immune pathways. Those are some highlights for momelotinib, marketed as OJJAARA by GSK. Momelotinib is approved by the FDA for the treatment of intermediate and high-risk myelofibrosis in adults with anemia. Momelotinib acts as an inhibitor of enzymes in the JAK family, as well as activin receptor-like kinase 2. As always, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this discussion of the approval of momelotinib. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.